Blackfishing. The women accused of pretending to be black by the BBC. Yes, these women you are seeing on the screen are apparently white women. In fact, one of them, she's apparently Polish. I cannot pronounce her last name, and I have many Polish friends, so you'll probably get mad at me, but I would imagine it's probably something like Brzostowska. I don't know, maybe if you're Polish, you can write it phonetically, that'd be great. This is a Polish woman. She does look black. Here's a quote. I've had no surgery, so I can't take off these lips. I can't remove my fake bum implants. What do you... Oh, shit. Okay. Over the past month... Over the past month, Aga... I can't pronounce that. Brzostowska has been labeled a blackfish. It's a term used for someone accused of pretending to be black or mixed race on social media. Ooh, I can think of some activists who do that. The suggestion Aga has been faking her race is news to her. The 20-year-old University of Birmingham student told Radio 1 Newsbeat her skin is not naturally not pale, but she does admit to making it darker. Basically, what they're saying is there are a ton of women on Instagram who pretend to be black for likes or whatever. I mean, she's got 3,000 likes. It's not bad, I guess. You can make money selling stuff if you get the traffic. With things like tanning, I don't think I've done anything in a malicious way. So I don't feel like I need to stop doing something because why would I stop doing something that's benefiting me or that I enjoy doing? Aga, who asked to be referred to as Alicia, says, she says she's not suggesting white privilege is not a thing, but wants to tell her critics the assumptions you're making are wrong. You literally changed your name from Aga to Alicia. Alicia? I can't pronounce that. Alicia is just one of a number of white Instagram influencers who've been accused of changing their features to make themselves look more like black women. People have pointed in their pictures that they have darker skin, fuller lips, bigger thighs, and bums, and hairstyles that include curls and braids. Sweden's Emma Hallberg, who has more than 260,000 Instagram followers, is the most famous. She had to defend herself after two photos of her went viral on social media. She's Swedish. Apparently, this is what she looks like in real life, and now she looks like this. It's like, you'd look really different. Someone said, white girls, if you want to pass as black, how about using your platforms to address the injustices and discrimination actual black people face? Don't just appreciate the people you are imitating. Somebody asked me why I thought people would want to pretend to be black. There's a lot of reasons. For one, social media has created advantages for people who are not white. If you repeatedly demonize white people and tell them they have white privilege and they're made to feel bad, well, then don't be surprised when some people want to be a different race. Don't be surprised when you find Rachel Dolezal, who we know is white, when she pretends to be black. Don't be surprised when there are high-profile activists like who claim to be biracial when clearly they are whiter than most people. Like, seriously. I have shown photos of this particular high-profile biracial activist, and people don't think he's biracial. Not at all. And you probably know who I'm talking about, but I'm going to leave his name out of it for the time being. Why? Why would someone want to pretend to be black? Well, for one, these women are making money. Another thing is, I guess that's actually just it. But with the idea of white privilege, I think that kind of gets to it too, that there are people who have found it lucrative to not be white. And thus, they have embraced certain movements and certain concepts. It's not just about Instagram and making money and being an influencer. I do not see myself as anything else than white, Emma told BuzzFeed. I get a deep tan naturally from the sun. Emma's defense is similar to the two women accused of blackfishing, spoken to by Newsbeat. Alicja, I have no idea how to say that, admits that two pictures of her, which were doing the rounds on Twitter, one from when she was 13 and one taken recently, don't look good for her. I understand why the Twitter thread was made, and it makes sense to use my pictures because without looking at anything or knowing me, it makes sense to put these two pictures together because obviously you can see a mad difference, a crazy difference. So I'm not really upset at the fact that someone used the pictures without knowing me. It makes sense of what they were trying to get across. Okay, here's what she used to look like when she was 13. Here's what she looks like now. Look, come on. She's clearly white. She's clearly doing something to make her skin darker. But I also want to point out, as much as people are upset about this, there are a lot of people who use skin bleaching cream. I think Sammy Sosa famously would like rub skin bleaching cream on himself all the time and made his skin much whiter. And a lot of people accuse Michael Jackson doing the same thing. Let's not get into the Michael Jackson thing because I don't know enough about it. Elijah claims the differences in her appearance shown in the two pictures is completely natural. The result of hard work in the gym and being fresh back from the holidays, braids included. And she thinks part of the reason people are surprised when they find out she's white is down to stereotypes about what Polish people should look like. Oh, that's it. Everybody's being racist towards Polish people. That's just what Polish people look like sometimes. Maybe they do. In fact, if you want to go by the traditional social justice model of diversity, what does a Polish person look like? Certainly there could be people who 100 years ago emigrated from Africa, and now they live in Poland, and they speak Polish, and they grew up in Poland, and they look like that, right? Isn't that fair to say? I guess the difference is when she's literally a white Polish woman and then all of a sudden turns black, yeah, something's up. Why is this a big deal? Blackfishing has been talked about a lot ever since writer Juana Thompson's Twitter thread, which highlighted women accused of blackfishing, went viral last month. Some people have been questioning why it's an issue. Dara Thurmond, a nurse from New York who's been vocal about blackfishing, told Radio 1 Newsbeats that black people just being ourselves has always been frowned upon. Well, I don't necessarily think so. I think some people are racist, for sure, but not, like, generally. She says her frustration comes when white women who appear to be posing as black don't know the struggle that black women go through just to be accepted as who they are. One argument I've heard too is that the problem is when people culturally appropriate, you know, black culture, or I think this is a much better example, they're trying to take the positive aspects of black culture that can benefit them, and at the end, and then at the end of the day, take off all the makeup and go live as a white person and enjoy the privileges befitting a white person. That's like one of the arguments I've heard that I think they kind of get at. Even now in certain workspaces, black women can't wear their natural hair out. They have to wear weave. I don't know why they have to do that. They have to press their hair so that it's straight, because to wear an afro or to wear braids or to wear locks is seen as unclean or untidy. It's not professional. Says who? You know, I often hear these things about what is or isn't acceptable, but it's often about what women find acceptable of other women. Like, I really doubt most guys would care what your hair looks like if you put it up in a fro. Like, sure, whatever. I mean, I certainly don't care. She says women accused of blackfishing are being unfair to black women who are trying to make it as influencers and get product endorsements on their own. You take away from them. Jaden Gumbayan is 19 from Jacksonville, Florida, and has also been accused of blackfishing. Like Alicia, she says she understands some of the black backlash against her, but denies pretending to be a different race to her own. And there she's wearing clothes, I guess. Who's your favorite YouTuber blogger? Comment with ideas for new content. She believes there's a fine line between appreciation and appropriation. It could be looked at as the biggest form of flattery to some black women or people of color. And to others, it's mimicking and taking their culture without knowing the history behind it, she says. I know that there are other influencers on Instagram and other celebrities. That is their intention. A name that's been mentioned in almost every written online and everything written online about blackfishing is Kardashian. It's because Kim in particular has been accused of appropriating black culture on several occasions down the years. You know, I really don't like the idea of cultural appropriation because, like, what are you implying? You're saying that it's not okay to engage in cultural activities from other groups? Are you saying we should segregate ourselves and not partake in other cultures? And what am I supposed to tell my parents who are not of the same race when they engage in each other's cultures? Look, I get it. There's a difference between appropriation and appreciation. But I think it's silly when you go after people for appropriation instead of education, right? You should tell them, hey, that's really cool you're doing this. Let me explain something to you so that you can improve upon your use of this cultural tradition or something, right? Isn't it the best thing to do so we can share in each other's cultures? The Kardashian effect has also been blamed for an apparent rise in young people seeking cosmetic surgeries. Oh, heavens. I also heard there's a thing that happens on Snapchat where because people have these filters all the time, they get surgery to, like, seriously, to, like, make the filters in real life on their face. Well, let's read on. I don't want to, this is kind of silly. We can appreciate their culture without having to do or wear their hairstyles or trying to act or be a certain way that we're not. There's only so much I can do when I don't feel like I've harmed or done anything in a malicious way. Will she change her pictures? I don't know what I can change because it's just me. Yes. I think social justice has made it lucrative to not be white. I mean, there's... Look, if you want to be an influencer, I really don't see why she can't be an influencer, this woman, right? She's white. Okay, be a white influencer. There are plenty. I know some. You don't have to be black to be an influencer. I think this is something different. It has nothing to do with trying to pretend to be black to get followers. I think it has to do with some kind of transracialism that we've been seeing. There are people who just want to look that way. And so they do what they can to look that way. And it has nothing to do with whether or not they wanted to be an influencer, because there are people who are white who are influencers. Anyway, let me just end by saying this. So long as you keep saying white people are a problem, you will see transracialism. Transracialism. You will see white people who don't want to be white, but you'll also see angry white people who don't like people who aren't white. This is my big problem with all this identitarianism stuff, is that it encourages this kind of behavior, and then they get mad at the behavior they encourage. If you're going to tell people being white is bad, why are you going to get mad at them when they try to not be white? It's your own doing. Anyway, it's ridiculous nonsense. Welcome to the world. This is how ridiculous and utterly nonsensical things have become. I've got another ridiculous and nonsensical video coming up right now, actually. Stick around.